Hi everyone, my name is Thomas Kim. Today is October 25th, 2019. This is my sixth episode about linear algebra and threading building blocks. In this episode, we will learn how to use optimized memory allocators and thread safe containers. If you haven't watched my first episode by clicking this link, please watch it now. Otherwise, you cannot follow current session and my future episode. Then come back to this session. In this episode, we will learn about TBB allocator, scalable allocator, and cache-aligned allocator, then container class called concurrent vector. More specifically, we will learn how to take advantage of these libraries, how to compile your program to use these advanced allocators. For more information, please double-click these links. You can read more about these allocator classes. In future episodes, I will explain one by one, but in this episode, I will demonstrate how to build, how to compile using these classes. In future episode, I will also talk about containers, threaded safe containers. In case of Intel threading building block, defines TBB hash compare, TBB hash class, concurrent unordered map, concurrent unordered multimap, concurrent bounded queue, concurrent priority queue, concurrent vector. These classes are very useful for multi-threading. By the time you watch this video, you can click this link and download the complete source code of this episode. Without further ado, let's get started. Start Visual Studio Code. Click New Folder, 06, Allocators. Click New File, alloc.cpp, hit Enter, Ctrl V. Define underscore use mass defines. This is for mathematical macro constant included talk play fun output HPP for optimized output included CMS for mathematical constants and functions included TBB, TBBH for Intel threading building block included TBB, TBB allocator H for TBB, TBB allocator. This header file is optional. Included TBB scalable allocator H for TBB scalable allocator. Included TBB concurrent vector for thread safe concurrent vector. Talk play fun stream auto NDL talk play fun NDL auto NL talk play fun NL for optimized output for flush out to console for new line character but does not flush out. If you have such skill, Ctrl Shift P, edit configuration JSON, you have to define this macro. About this, I explained in my first episode. Sorry, it should be SS stream, string stream. Void test allocators, std vector int default vctr. We will initialize 1, 2, 3, 4. This is identical to std vector int std allocator int. If you right click, go to definition, then it uses allocator. This is std allocator. std vector int tbb tbb allocator int tbb v VCTR. We also initialize 1, 2, 3, 4. TVV allocator uses MALLOC and pre C standard function. STD vector int TVV scalable allocator int scalable VCTR 1, 2, 3, 4. For fattest allocation and deallocation of memory. STD vector int TVV cache aligned allocator int aligned vector VCTR 1, 2, 3, 4 to prevent cache pooling or false sharing for optimal cache access. Now we print out stream default VCTR default VCTR NL. We put carriage return but does not flush the output to console for optimization purpose. I will copy this part, paste TVV VCTR TVV VCTR. Copy once again, scalable VCTR scalable VCTR. This is aligned VCTR. Now int main, copy this function, paste it here. Now I will explain how to compile this. Start command prompt. This is for GNU C++ and Clang compiler command prompt. If you haven't watched my previous video, you have to watch this video to make command prompt and environment variable settings. Otherwise, you cannot build. Now here, dir cd06 allocators. Now we are using Clang compiler, Clang++, std, C++17, sorry, it should be equal, C++17. Then you can put, this is alphabet O3, this is not 03, this is alphabet O3 for maximal optimization. Then ALLOC, CPP, this is our file to compile, LTVV, this is for threading building block, LTVV MALLOC, this is for scalable allocator. Then hit enter. So we have nothing to see yet because we haven't flushed it. So I will flush and there. Now we have to flush to console. Okay? Build once again. I will define O. O means output. CEXE. Output file CEXE will be created. Hit enter. So CLS DIR CEXE is created. So please remember this command line syntax. Copy, paste it here. For release, build. With optimization, switch, alphabet O3. Now for debugging build, in case of debugging build, we do not use optimization switch. We can say O1 or O0. Then we have to provide debug. Debug. Also here, debug. For debugging build without optimization. Now we have to provide another command called G. This is for debugging switch. Debugging switch. Now we compile for debugging switch. It's probably O0 or the debugging switch should be, it should be debug build. Don't forget, it should be O0. This is for debugging. Okay, we built debug build. I will copy this command prompt. Copy, paste it here. Now for GNU compiler, G++, the option is the same. Let's try G, hit enter. Okay, now it works. So this is for GNU compiler with debugging. For I will just copy it, paste like this. Also, please note that this is for debugging build. Now let's think about Microsoft compiler. In case of Microsoft, we have to use this command prompt. We created this command prompt in this episode. So if you haven't watched it, you have to watch it. Dir cd06 allocators. I will delete all exe. Then cl is for Microsoft compiler. ehsc sdd C++17. Microsoft compiler is not optimized by default. So alloc.cpp, we will provide tbb malloc.lib. Okay, this is release build, so we use md. In case of release build, md is optional. Then fe, output is mexe, hit enter. So it built successfully, but it contains deprecated functionality. To suppress this warning, right click, go to definition, then we have to define this macro. Copy. In the command prompt, we can define macro like this. D, phased, then hit enter. Now it compiles without complaining. So I will copy this syntax. Copy. Then paste it here. For Microsoft compiler. If you want to optimize, then you can give switch O2/O2. Okay? Hit enter. This is optimized build. So I will copy this part once again. Copy and paste. Microsoft compiler optimized release build. You have to provide MDD. Okay, this is for debugging. Now remove the optimization. Then it should be debug. Okay? Hit enter. Then it built in debug mode. So I will copy this line. Copy, paste it here for Microsoft compiler for debugging build. I hope you understand this concept. Now let's think about thread safe concurrent vector or containers. I will copy this part. I copied and pasted test concurrent vector. Instead of std vector, tbb concurrent vector. I will copy once and I will modify it to here too. Now I will call this function, copy, paste it here. I will disable it using GNU compiler. It built, it works using Clang compiler. This is Clang compiler debug mode. It works using Microsoft compiler. Hit enter. It works. So if you want to use thread safe concurrent vector, then you can use like this. I hope you understand these things. Sorry, I just found I made a mistake. So this is debug build. In case of debug build, you have to provide DTBB use debug 1. Hit enter. In case of GNU compiler, you also provide DTBB use debug 1. So both compiler works. In case of Microsoft compiler, this is Microsoft debug build. You need to provide D underscore debug in debug build. So it works. I'm very sorry I made this mistake. In future episode, I will talk more about thread safe, concurrent vector, concurrent containers, and advanced use of allocators. I will upload the complete source code to my website. By the time you watch this video, you can click this link and download the complete source code. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.